Thank you. Good morning.
Morning.
Please be seated. A very warm welcome to you all to our joint ministerial service held in St. Edmund's Church, Crickhowell, a place where worship has been offered for the last many centuries. To all those who are joining us online, a special, very warm welcome to you all from whichever part of the world you have joined us. We pray that may our collective worship resonate with the true spirit of unity. A special welcome greetings to Dr. Rowan Williams, who made our Palm Sunday weekend very special. His lecture yesterday was very enriching. We are truly fortunate. By the grace God has given us the talent we have in our area. Our worship today is going to be led by St. Ketuk Choir and St. Edmund's Worship Group. St. Ketuk Ministry Area brings 10 churches from this area together to create a family of people who love God and want to serve the area where God has put us in. We are dedicated to nurturing spiritual growth of gathering as God's people, growing in the likeness of Jesus, and going forth in the power of the Spirit. As part of the Anglican tradition, the Church in Wales, we extend a warm welcome to people from all Christian denominations, as well as those with different beliefs or none at all, inviting them to embark on a journey with us to explore the teaching of Jesus Christ through and with the Word of God and to have a personal encounter with Him. The order of service is shown on the screen. At the moment, the screen is blank. All that you need is there, but if you still need some hard copies, please see people at the back. If you need facilities, we have a restroom, please. Again, see our lovely hospitality team who will look after you. Please do stay for the tea and coffee afterwards. Let us be still for a moment, preparing ourselves to come before God, our merciful Judge and our Redeemer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Grace and peace be with you.
And keep you in the love of Christ.
Let us say together, Heavenly Father,
we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and have failed to do what we ought to have done. We are sorry and truly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past. Lead us in his way to walk as children of light. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you and set you free from sin, strengthen you in goodness, and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We stand for the hymn.
Oh,
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who in your tender love towards the human race sent your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to take upon him our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross, grant that we may follow the example of his patience and humility and also be made partakers of his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Zechariah. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. Righteous and having salvation is he, humble and mounted on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem, and the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall speak peace to the nations. His rule shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm for this morning is Psalm 118, verses 1 and 2, and then verses 19 to 29. And we'll say it responsorially, so if you will join me, I'll do the odd verses, and if you will join me for the second verses. I'll do the odd verses, and you'll do the even verses. Sorry. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever.
Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord.
This is the gate of the Lord, the righteous shall enter through it.
I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation.
The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
This is the Lord's doing. It is marvellous in our eyes.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Save us, we pray, O Lord. O Lord, we pray, give us success.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord.
The Lord is God, and he has made his light to shine upon us. Bind the festal sacrifice with cords up to the horns of the altar.
You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, and I will extol you.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever.
Thank you.
The epistle reading will be in Welsh, and for those of you who are unable to read it, it will be on the screen behind me. And also, if you have a song sheet with a large print edition, it's printed in English on those as well. Y darlleniad o lythyr Paul at y Philippiaid. Dylai eich agwedd chi fod yr un fath ag agwedd y Mesoea Iesu. Roedd e'n rhannu'r un natur a Duw, heb angen ceisio gwneud ei hun yn gydradd a Duw. Ond dewisodd roi ei hun yn llwyr i wasanaethu eraill a gwneud ei hun yn geithwas a dod ato ni fel person dynol. Roedd yn amlwg i bawb ei fod yn ddyn. Yna diraddio ei hun fwy fyth a bod yn ifydd hyd yn oed i farw. Ie, trwy cael ei ddienyddio ar y groes. Felly dyma Duw yn ei ddyrchafu i'r safle uchaf a rhoi'r enw pwysica un iddo. Bydd pob glin yn plygu i enw Iesu, pawb yn y nefoedd, ar y ddaear a than y ddaear. A bydd pawb yn cydnabod mae Iesu Grist ydy'r arglwydd ac yn rhoi clod i Dduw y Tad. Dyma air yr arglwydd. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when they drew near to Jerusalem and came to Bethphage, to the Mount of Olives, then Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, go into the village in front of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her.
Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say this: the Lord needs them, and he will send them at once. This took place to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet, saying, say to the daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming to you humble and mounted on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put on them their cloaks, and he sat on them. Most of the crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. And the crowds that went before him and those that followed him were shouting, Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest! And when he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred up, saying, who is this? And the crowd said, this is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth of Galilee. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please sit down. When we go to the cinema, or the theatre, or when we watch something on screen, we may very well be approaching it with rather different attitudes. There are times, aren't there, when all you really feel you can cope with is Downton Abbey or Midsummer Murders. At the end of a long day, you don't particularly want to sit down with a gritty drama about life in the back streets of Baltimore, or a Soviet film of King Lear. But there are also experiences in cinema and theatre, and indeed watching on the small screen too, where you can't but come away feeling, actually, I know more and feel more at the end of this than when I began. I'm not quite sure what I know, and I'm not quite sure what I feel, but I sense that there's a bit more of me at the end of this than there was at the beginning. And sometimes, we go to the cinema or the theatre or we watch something on the screen hoping that our imaginations will be enlarged in that way, hoping that what happens will help us to grow. Holy Week is a week of drama. A week in which things are enacted, not just read about or thought about, but acted out. We put our bodies where our minds are. We don't simply say, how very interesting that Jesus entered Jerusalem on a donkey on Palm Sunday. We walk around and we wave palms. On Maundy Thursday, in many of the great churches and cathedrals of the Christian world, you don't just say, Jesus took off his outer garments, girded himself with a towel, and washed the disciples' feet. The priest or bishop or archbishop will actually go and do some foot washing. We put our bodies where our minds are. And that's where we begin to learn and grow. The drama of Holy Week is not just, with all due respect, Downton Abbey or Midsummer Murders. This is a drama where, increasingly, we are involved. I'll come back to that word in a moment. But we're introduced quite gently to this. On Palm Sunday, primarily, we think about the spectacle, the wonderful, triumphant spectacle of Jesus being welcomed as he deserves to be. And if we'd been there, either as Jesus' disciples on Palm Sunday or among the crowds that welcomed him, we might well have thought, What a wonderful sight to see. Still a little bit at the spectator end of the spectrum. A little bit at that end which says, that's a very fascinating and inspiring thing out there. And then, of course, Holy Week, so to speak, turns on us and draws us in. By the time we get to Good Friday, it's very definitely not something that's happening out there. It's something which involves me, something which is digging out new places in my heart and soul, something which is changing me. So that when we come to the great explosion of triumph at the end of the week, at Easter Day itself, we are not quite the same people we were on Palm Sunday. We are not just involved, we are committed. We're not just spectators, we're participants. Some of you may know the old joke about the difference between involvement and commitment. Think of a breakfast of bacon and eggs. The chicken is involved, but the pig is committed. And during this week, we move from involvement to commitment. We move from simply looking at what God is doing, as it were, at a bit of a distance, to being drawn into what God is doing and letting God come alive more deeply and fully in ourselves. In our prayers and reflections during this week, we let ourselves be hollowed out a bit. We let God make more space in our hearts and souls that he may fill with his grace and his hope. Did you pick up that wonderful phrase in the Old Testament lesson? Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. What a wonderful, paradoxical image that is. Prisoners of hope. We can't stop hoping, even though everything around us and sometimes everything inside us tells us to give up. Unfortunately, we can't. We're committed. We're the bacon, not the eggs. We are there, in it. God is at work in us. And this imprisonment by hope, being gripped by hope, this is what truly sets us free. That's the trajectory, that's the movement of Holy Week. Involvement to commitment, spectator to participant, onlooker to being part of the drama itself, in which God is spelling out in us and for us who he is and what he's doing. This morning, some of us walked from Llangattock here across a bridge. And of course, that's a wonderful symbol of the bridge building we seek to do all the time between different communities, including different Christian communities. Because, you know, they tell me that even quite closely neighboring congregations don't always see completely eye to eye. I don't know if that's true or not. But perhaps we can think of another kind of bridge that we're in the process of crossing. The bridge from involvement to commitment. The bridge from being a spectator to being a participant. The bridge that allows us to be caught up into what God is doing for us, in us, and through us. How we become part of what God does for and to the world we all share. A world which certainly needs prisoners of hope to be around. And perhaps we can think of that bridge from involvement to commitment as reflecting the very nature of God. God who is never a spectator of the human world. But as St. Paul's words this morning reminded us, God who builds the bridge into the center of our human lives and rebuilds our humanity, remakes our hearts from the inside. God is never just involved. God is always committed, utterly committed to us. And he asks of us that we give trust and commitment to him so that he can do what he wants in our world, so that he can build up the peace, the justice, the reconciliation for which human beings are hungry, desperately hungry. As we start Holy Week then, set your foot on that bridge. Start walking towards a fuller and richer commitment. God has already come to meet you. God has already crossed the bridge into your heart. But we still have to take the steps we need to take to reach him, to let him in, to let him do what he is all too eager to do in us and for us and with us. Walk that journey from being a spectator to being part of the action, from involvement to commitment. Because in that commitment, as we'll discover yet again next Sunday, in that commitment, our life is turned inside out, glorified, enriched beyond imagination, transfigured forever. There'll be more room in us, more space for God, and so more joy, more hope, more energy for joining in God's work of transforming our wounded world. God help us take that journey and bring us across that bridge. May God turn us from chickens into pigs.
Please stand and let us confess our faith in the words of Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. But for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Virgin Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Please sit or kneel.
Holy God, holy and strong, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. O Lord, our heavenly Father, high and mighty, King of kings and Lord of lords, the only ruler of princes, who from thy throne beholds all dwellers upon the earth, most heartily we beseech you with your favour to behold our most gracious sovereign Lord, King Charles, and so replenish him with the grace of your Holy Spirit, that he may incline always to your will and walk in your way. Endue him plenteously with heavenly gifts. Restore his body, heal his flesh, deliver him from his pain, and grant him in health and wealth long to live. Strengthen him that he may vanquish and overcome all his enemies. And finally, after this life, he may attain everlasting joy and felicity through Jesus Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Almighty God, the fount of all goodness, we humbly beseech you to bless Queen Camilla William, the Prince of Wales, Catherine, the Princess of Wales, delivering her too from her afflictions and her maladies, from her pain and her suffering. We pray, Father, for the royal family. Endue them with your Holy Spirit. Enrich them with your heavenly grace. Prosper them with all happiness and bring them to your eternal kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Most gracious God, we humbly beseech you as for this kingdom in general, especially for the High Court of Parliament, under our most religious and gracious King at this time assembled, for Rishi Sunak and for Keir Starmer, for all our MPs, for the Cabinet and for the Shadow Cabinet, for the Senate members, for the councillors, that you, O God, will be pleased to direct and prosper all their consultations to the advancement of your glory, for the good of your church, for the safety, the honour and the welfare of our sovereign and all his dominions, that things may be so ordered and settled by their endeavours upon our best and surest foundations, that peace and happiness, truth and justice, religion and piety may be established among us for all generations. We pray, Father, for these and all other necessaries for them and for us, for your whole church, we humbly beg in your name and the mediation of Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O most almighty God, King of all kings and governor of all things, whose power no creature is able to resist, to whom belongs justly to punish sinners and to be merciful to them that truly repent. We pray, Father, save and deliver us, we humbly beseech you, from the hands of our enemies, from all who seek our harm, to our distress and to the distress of our neighbours, for the breaching of the peace of our realm. Abate their pride, assuage their malice, confound their devices, that we, being armed by your defence, may be preserved for evermore from all perils, to glorify you, and you who are the only giver of victory, through the merits of your only Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Almighty and everlasting God, who alone works great marvels, we pray, Father, send down upon our bishops and curates and all congregations committed to their charge the healthful spirit of your grace, that they may truly please you and pour upon them the continual dew of your blessing. We pray, Father, most earnestly for our gracious Bishop John Lomas, that you'll endue him with the heavenly wisdom, with nobility, with truth, with honour, that he may justly and honestly and uprightly serve your people, that he might behold the gospel among us and be a true shepherd of this flock. We pray, Father, grant this, O Lord, for the honour and advocate of our advocate and mediator. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
O God, the creator and preserver of all mankind, we humbly beseech you for all sorts and conditions of men, that you be pleased to make your ways known among them, your saving health to all nations. More especially we pray for the good estate of your universal church, that it may be so guided and governed by your good spirit, that all who profess and call themselves Christians may be led into the way of truth, that we might hold the faith in the unity of the Spirit, in the bond of peace, in righteousness of life, that we, your people, who are called by your name, might be the spotless and lovely bride worthy of the Lamb, your healthful body, adorned and beautified with good works, a household in which your name is honoured and your ways observed and your words are heard. Finally, we commend to your fatherly goodness all those who are in ways afflicted and distressed in mind and body and estate. We pray, Father, for the poor people of Gaza. We pray, Father, deliver them from the tyranny of Hamas. We pray, Father, deliver the hostages back to their families, and those who have died, let their bodies be returned for honourable burial. We pray, Father, that good government will arise in Gaza, that they might live in peace with their neighbours, that the Israelis will go home and be no more insecure. We pray, Father, for the people of Ukraine. You'll deliver them from the hand of their enemies, from all who hate them, for those who would destroy their property. We pray, Lord, that one day they will rebuild their land, in truth, in righteousness, in peace, in justice, according to your ways and the foundations of your testimonies. We pray that it might please you to comfort and relieve them according to their several necessities, giving them patience under their sufferings and a happy issue out of all their afflictions. And this we beg for Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And Father, we pray for our land, for the lovely land in which we live, for the garden you have entrusted to us. We pray, Father, deliver this land from stupidity and negligence and every wicked and evil way that destroys and lays waste. We pray, Father, show us how to be good stewards of this land, to restore it to its health and its beauty and its wholesomeness, the loveliness and the wisdom with which you made it in the beginning, that we, being worthy stewards and guardians of this land, might honour you with the way in which we treat it. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and does promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will grant their requests. Fulfil now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of your servants, as most be expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the world to come, everlasting joy and felicity. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We bless your name.
Blessed are the peacemakers. They shall be called children of God. We meet in the name of Christ and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace of Christ with one another. Thank you. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Rimodd ôl swper, mae gymerodd y cwpan, ac wedi rhoi ti diolch, mae rhoddodd iddynt gan ddywedyd, Yfwch o hwn bawb, oherwydd hwn yw fy ngwaed ar gyfamod newydd, a dywellir drosoch a thraslawer, maddaiant pechodau. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer to you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
So we unite our prayers with those of the Church Universal, saying in our own language the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
sanctified be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lamb of God, who take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you. Let me say the word, and I shall be healed.
Body of Christ. Yes.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you humbled yourself in taking the form of a servant, and in obedience died on the cross for our salvation. Give us the mind to follow you and to proclaim you as Lord and King, to the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
We pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. To him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
As part of the notices, a big thank you to Bishop Rowan Williams for being with us and all those who have worked tirelessly to make it happen. In anticipation of Jesus' entry to Jerusalem, he instructed two disciples, directing them, go into the village in front of you and you will find a donkey and a colt, untie it, bring it to me. This was not a straightforward for us. A, we didn't have two people to instruct. We had only one wonderful Dawn to ask her, and she had walked this morning nearly 5 miles with Donkey. Let's give big hands to Dawn and Donkey. As we approach Holy Week, the ministry area will host various services in our churches. Look on your notice boards, our ministry area and St. Edmund's website, or speak to one of our team members. We will be more than happy to tell you what's going on for children, for young people, and for various other services. Additionally, we will screen the Amazing Grace film, which was a base for our Lent study this year, on Wednesday at 7:30 in St. Edmund's Church. Please stay for tea and coffee. And when we go out, please the clergy and the choir and the worship group and anyone who would like to join us outside the church for a group photo. But don't leave after that. Come in and have a fellowship and tea and coffee. And now let us sing our final hymn.
Thank you.
peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Bendis du hotashliog, atad, armab, arasbridglan, avo an echplith, akadriga garachwean wastad. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.